Good morning students, welcome in this class. This is class 8, subject social science and we are studying about civics chapter 2, secularism. It is the second lecture of this chapter and in this lecture the topics which are to be discussed are like these. First one, what is Indian secularism? Second, objectives of secularism and third one, how Indian secularism differ from other democratic country. So let's we start today's discussion. Yes friends, in today's discussion first we will recapitulate our previous topic in brief. Yes, in yesterday lecture we have studied about meaning of secularism. Yes, secularism means that the separation of religion from the state. Means secularism term defines the separations between the power of religion and the power of the state, and it is important for a country to function democratically. Understood beta? And why this separation is done, why it is necessary? Yes, the separation is done on two bases or for two main reasons. First is there that it is done to prevent the domination of one religion over another, and the second is to protect the freedom of individuals to come out of their religion, embrace another religion or have the freedom to interpret religious teaching differently. Understood? Okay, and in today's lecture we will discuss about Indian secularism. Okay, so let's start today's discussion. First, Indian secularism. According to Indian constitution, our country is a secular. What means that Indian constitution defines the provisions of India as a secular state. Means in India, there is no official religion. Indian state does not promote or give importance to any one particular religion. Here, all religions are given equal respect. Indian secularism does protect individuals' religious freedom by maintaining a separation from religion. Means the Indian constitution contains fundamental rights, and these rights are very important because they protect us against state power as well as against the domination of the majority. So the Indian constitution allows individuals religious freedom, or means the individuals the freedom to live by their religious beliefs and practices as they interpret these. And so our constitution gives religious freedom to all, and to maintain it, India adopted a strategy of separating the power of religion and the power of state. And Indian state is not ruled by a religious group. Okay, means all religions are given equal respect. Okay, and people are free to follow any religion according to their choice. Okay, that there is no discrimination on the basis of religion. Next one, objectives of a secular state. Yes, then there are three main objectives of a secular state. First one, one religious community should not dominate the other one. Yes friends, and the people belonging to one religious community should not dominate those who are in a minority. So the main objectives which are to be achieved by a secular state are, like in India, the people of different communities live. Means the people, those who believe in different religion, those who follow different cultures and customs. Okay. So, to protect the domination of one religious community, means those who are in majority. Okay. Over the minority religious communities, that this type of protections of the religious domination is the main objective of a secular state. Okay, and one religious community should not dominate the other one, and the state will never enforce any religion or take away the citizens' religious freedom. Okay, means the state cannot force any citizens to follow any particular religion and it cannot interfere in the religious matter of any citizen. Okay, means here all citizens have religious freedom. But beta, if we talk of miss about other countries like which we have studied in our previous lecture, that example of Saudi Arabia, okay, Israel, where the people do not have religious freedom. Like if we take the example of Saudi Arabia, as no, Saudi Arabia is a Muslim dominated country. So here the people, those who are non-Muslim, means believe in any other religion like Hindus, Christians, so means they are not allowed to practice their religious beliefs. They are not allowed to build temples, churches, means they do not have religious freedom. But India is a secular state and here all people have religious freedom. Now, ways to prevent domination. Okay, actually Indian state works in various ways to prevent the domination, religious domination. And first, it uses adopted a strategy of distancing itself from religions. Means Indian secularism works in various ways to prevent religious dominations, and for that it adopted a strategy of distancing itself from religions. And the Indian state is not ruled by a religious group and it also does not support any one religion. And in our country, like government places like law courts, police stations, government schools and offices are not supposed to demonstrate or promote any one religions. So first strategy, distancing itself from religions, means a secular state that means does not interfere in the religious matters of citizens. It kept it, okay, means it maintains a distance between the religious matter and the state power. And second, the state is not ruled by a particular religious group. Means in a secular state, that means no particular religion is given importance. Means all religions are given equal importance. Okay, and a secular state does not promote or support any one religion. In Indian government spaces like law courts, police stations, government schools and offices are not supposed to display or promote any one religion. Understood? Yes. Now, in this basis, one story is given. After reading that, you can understand it well. In a government school in Simapur, students wants to celebrate a religious festival. Yes, students, actually, first I want to give one example. Like in schools, we always that celebrate national festivals like Independence Day, Republic Day, but we never celebrate religious festivals in the schools like Diwali, Holi. Okay, means this type of religious festivals are not celebrated in government schools or organization. Why? Because India is a secular state and it does not give importance to any particular religion. So on this basis, one story is there that in a government school in Simapur, students want to celebrate a religious festivals, and for that they seek permission from their Miss Sir. And Sir, there is a big religious festival next month. So we have never celebrated it in school. So can we do it in this year? So they were asking, they were seeking permissions to celebrate a religious festival in their school. Okay, but what sir replied, I am afraid that it is not possible, Rekha. Why? Because this is a government school and we can't give importance to any one religion. Private school may do that, but government schools do not celebrate any religious festivals in the school premises. So the most religious festival are public holidays, so that we can celebrate these at home. Okay, means we can celebrate religious festivals at our home in the same manner, in the same practices in which we believe or in which we want to celebrate. Okay, so we don't give to support or importance any particular religions that religious festivals are not celebrated in the school or miss government organizations. Understood? Yes. Now the second way to prevent dominations. Indian secularism follows a strategy of non-interference. Okay, beta. Non-interference, like means, as I told that in Indian state or Indian secular state does not interfere in the religious matters of citizens. Okay, here I also give one example. For example, to respect the sentiments of all religions, the state makes certain exceptions, means in laws, for particular religious communities. Yes, friends, as we know that it is a traffic rule in India that means people must wear helmet while driving a two-wheeler. But have you seen a Sikh people? Means they never or don't wear a helmet while driving a two-wheeler, and for that they have not fined also. But if any other people is there or not wearing the helmet, so for that they or he has to fine. Okay, but why is Sikh people that have not pay the fine? Actually, as we know that in Sikh religion, that is very important and the part of their religions to wear a pagri. And as a secular state, the government or the Indian state cannot interfere in the religious sentiments of the citizens. That's why. Okay, so here one story is given that a group of friends who have recently bought scooters are meeting to go for a ride together. So I hope you have a helmet. You know, the law in Delhi requires that you wear one. Why are not you wearing a helmet? Do you want to be fined? Don't worry, I will not be fined. Why he will not be fined? Because he is a Sikh people. Hey Paramjit, why would not you be fined? For Sikh, wearing a pagri is very important part of our religion. So the government cannot force me to wear a helmet. So why government can't force him to wear a helmet? Because as a secular state, the government cannot interfere in the religious beliefs of the citizens. So understood? Yes. Now the third way to prevent domination, Indian secularism adopted a strategy of intervention. Yes, students, and the Indian secularism sometimes work out the domination through a strategy of intervention in two forms. First in the form of prevention and second in the form of support. Now we will discuss about it. Like, in order to prevent religious based exclusion and discrimination of lower caste, the Indian constitution constitution bans untouchability. As we know, beta, untouchability, like in the past also and now also in some areas, it is presented that some people are considered lower caste peoples, okay, and they are treated very badly by the high caste peoples. Okay, so means at that time this is the part of their religious belief. Okay, so but it was not in the favor or not beneficial for all the other peoples, and that it was you can say an examples of the violations of the fundamental rights of the citizens. So for that in India, the untouchability was removed, and in this way that the government means could interfere in the religious beliefs of the people. So means that I told that there is the two way, in the support and in prevention. Okay, and if we talk about the support, that it call be also in the form of support, that Indian constitutions grants the right to religious communities, okay, to set up their own schools and colleges. So understood, beta, means the Indian secularism works to prevent religious domination in the three ways. First way is that it adopted a strategy of distancing itself from religion. Second way, that the strategy of non-interference. And the third one is strategy of interventions. So understood? Now I am repeating it. Listen again, that what are the three ways or what are the various ways to prevent religious dominations. So the three main ways to prevent religious domination. First one is distance from religion. Just I told you that India uses a strategy of distancing itself from religions. And second one, strategy of non-interference, means Indian secularism works to prevent religious domination through the strategy of non-interference, means non-interfering in the religious matters of citizens. Okay. And it is also means important, or it signifies that in order to respect the sentiments to all religions and not to interfere with religious practices, and the state makes certain exceptions also. We have discussed about these exceptions with the help of an example of wearing helmet for Sikh people. And the next one is there, the third one, strategy of intervention. So understood? Yes. Now about the how Indian secularism differ from other democratic countries. Understood, friends? Yes. As we know beta that many other democratic countries also have adopted the secularism, but Indian secularism differ from other democratic countries. Here example of America is given. Okay. Yes, friends, actually the strict separation between religion and state in American secularism, while Indian secularism states can intervene in religious affairs. Okay, actually the Indian secularism is different from that of other democratic countries like United States of America. And what is the main difference between it? Actually, there is a strict separation between religion and the state in American secularism. Means in American secularism that the state cannot interfere in any matter, okay, of the that religion or the state. They are totally separated from each other. Not in any case they can interfere. Means state cannot interfere in the religious matter of citizens in any condition. But while if you talk about the Indian secularism state can intervene. And we have read the example also like untouchability. Yes or no? Means untouchability is abolished from India, and this is the example of the strategy of intervening in the religious affairs. Okay. So in this way that the Indian secularism is separated from the other democratic countries. Okay, so in Indian secularism the state is not so strictly separate from religion, and it does maintain a principled distance vice versa in religions. So this means any interference in religion by the state has to be based on the ideals laid down in our constitution. Means the Indian state can interfere in the religious matters, but these matters means they must be based on the ideals which are laid down or given in our constitution. Understood beta? Yes. So in this way our today's lecture is completed. So now I'll assign you some homework, some question answers, which answer you have to write in your FAIR notebook. In which first question is there that what do you mean by freedom of interpret? Okay. Second one, how is Indian secularism different from that of American secularism? Just we have discussed, means Indian secularism differ from American secularism in the term of strictness. So you have to describe about it. Next one is there, what are the three main objectives of a secular state? In the starting of the chapter I told you three main objectives of a secular state. In what ways does the Indian secularism work to prevent religious dominations? I told you the three ways to prevent religious domination. Okay, in which the three way, that keeping it or separating distance from religion, second strategy of non-interference, and third one strategy of interventions. So you will describe about it. Okay beta, now we will have a discussion on the homework solution, in which the question answer which were given to you, so in which first is there, what does term secularism refer to? The term secularism refers to the separation of the power of religion from the power of the state. Understood? Yes. Next one, What examples does history provides us on the ground of religion? Yes, history provides us with several examples of discrimination, exclusion and persecution on the ground of religion. Like in the example of religious discrimination, we have read the example of Saudi Arabia, where non-Muslim peoples are not allowed to practice their religious beliefs or customs. They are not allowed to build temples, churches. This is their exclusion, that means not considered as the part of community. And third one is their persecution, means treated badly on the basis of religion matter. Okay, these were some example, and we have studied about all this world example in our previous lecture. Yes, next, what happened in the Jewish state of Israel? Yes, Muslims and Christians minorities were treated badly in the Jewish state of Israel. Yes, in the Israel, there is means Muslims and Christians are in minority form, means they are in very less numbers. So that's why means they were treated badly on the basis of religion matter. Next, how are non-Muslim treated in Saudi Arabia? Already we have discussed about it. Like in Saudi Arabia, non-Muslims are not allowed to build a temple, church, etc. And they also cannot get in a public place for prayer. Understood? So means in this way we can say that India is a secular state. Here all people have equal rights. They are given religious freedom. People are free to follow any religion according to their choice. So understood, beta? Yes. And now last question, what is secularism? So here you have to define the term secularism in detail. The Indian constitution contains fundamental rights. These rights are very important because they protect us against state power as well as against the domination of the majority. The Indian constitution allows individuals the freedom to live their religious belief and practices as they interpret this. So Indian constitution adopted the term of secularism, and the term secularism refers to the separation between the power of religion and the power of state. So understood the meaning of secularism? Mainly secularism terms define separation between the power of religion and power of state. Means state does not promote any religion, okay, and does not give importance to any particular religions, and for that it adopted the policy of distancing from religion and strategy of non-interference and strategy of non-interventions. So understood, students? Yes. So in this way our today's lecture is completed. Tomorrow we will meet again with our next lecture, means summary lecture of this chapter. Okay. Yes, friends, yes, I wanted to tell you one more thing. Beta, when you send your homework on email ID, then send your homework with proper format, with your name, class, roll numbers and father name. Okay, daily I am receiving many homework mails, and in which that no information is related to you, in which class or sections you are. Okay, so next time that send your homework with proper format. Thank you.